DMK chief Karunanidhi has threatened to quit the UPA. In fact, if his demands are not met, Karunanidhi says he will try and pull out. In fact, he says there is no point in staying with the alliance if India does not back the US resolution. In fact, let's go across to Shabir. Before that, let's listen into what Karunanidhi said in Chennai this afternoon.
I have written this letter with immense mental agony and feeling of having been let down by the government of India. I wish to point out that the government of India should take appropriate steps to incorporate the amendments of the amendments to the resolution as follows. Declares that genocide and war crimes had been committed and inflicted on the Edam Tamils by the Sri Lankan army and the administrators. And strongly urges the establishment of a credible and independent International Commission of Investigation in the time-bound manner into the allegations of war crimes, crimes against humanity, violations of international human rights law, violations of international humanitarian law, and the crime of genocide against the Tamil people.
And Shabir is joining us live. Shabir, in fact, he made that statement in English and he said that there was no point. In fact, he's urging India to take a tough stance, but we understand he's also made it clear that there's no point in staying in the alliance if India doesn't take a tough stance.
Well, exactly. Karunanidhi has made it very clear this time around, saying that if India doesn't make the amendments that he has demanded for, then there is no point in continuing in this alliance. It will be meaningful. And when asked a specific question, what if the Indian government does not bring these amendments, he made it very clear that then it will be doubtful. The continuation of the relationship between the DMK and the Congress will be doubtful, and it will be certain that things will not be the same anymore. So Karunanidhi has made it very clear at this point in time. And also the problem here is that he is also under a lot of pressure, like the central government, because the pro-Tamil parties are questioning every day on the stand that is being taken by Karunanidhi, why he is still aligning with the Congress. So at this point in time, he wants things to make it very things to calm down, and he wants to do some kind of damage control, and that's why Karunanidhi has taken this extreme step of threatening the central government, because he has no other choice. And sources in the DMK says that this time around Karunanidhi is extremely serious in this particular issue.